Welcome to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. Assistant Professor Hanna Terletska in our Department of Physics and Astronomy was one of the first two MTSU professors to be recognized by the National Science Foundation as one of the nation's top young faculty members. She joins us today via Zoom to talk about her research, her love of teaching, and the importance of inspiring young women to pursue careers in science. Professor, welcome to Out of the Blue.
Thank you very much.
We are so very proud of your achievement, but I hope I could get you to describe the honor you've received from the National Science Foundation and what that means not only to you personally, but to our university.
I, together with another faculty from MTSU, Seth Jones from Educational Department, we both got the first MTSU NSF Career Awards. For my research, it will help me to further continue to do cutting edge research in quantum materials, educate students, and promote women in science and STEM. And for MTSU, I think this shows that how successful the efforts that have been taken by administration, department chairs, dean, president, have been towards the moving towards the research direction, promoting research infrastructure at MTSU.
Let's talk about first the topic that you're going to be exploring thanks to this grant. Describe your project and make it so that hosts of television programs can follow along.
This NSF will fund the research on this quantum material. So this is computational and theoretical study of novel materials. They don't happen in nature naturally. They are man-made in the labs, but they have very exotic and fascinating properties. And most importantly, they can have a useful application in various technologies. So we can use these quantum materials to build better batteries, to build better and efficient computers and electronics, also solar cells. And in particular, my research will be on so-called high-temperature superconductors. So, for example, if you have cables that bring electricity or current to you, to your homes, right, to bring light into your homes, when you touch the cables, it's kind of hot. Right, because we lose energy due to the heat. But superconducting cables, when you heat them to very low temperatures, they can conduct electricity without any loss of energy. Okay? And imagine having these superconducting cables all over the United States. We will get a lot of energy with very little cost. We do use them already in MRI, in medicines. We use them in energy transmission in storage. We use them already in, for example, in Germany and in Japan for transformation, transportation.
I want to key on an important element of this. When the provost came to my office and talked about you and Professor Jones, not only was this a great honor for your research, but also there was this recognition of you being so young in your career, so getting this almost out of the gates. And you've been at MTSU for about 2.5 years. Talk about what this means to get this so early in your academic career.
Yeah, it's very exciting. I in the beginning, I didn't believe that I got it. but it's huge encouragement because this will help me so much to pursue my career goals, research career goals. Since coming to MTSU, I established 3 different collaborations with different groups in Oak Ridge, continued collaboration with University of Michigan, with Florida State, with Louisiana State, with recent collaboration with University of Augsburg in Germany. And this helps me to go and promote my research and also to promote MTSU.
So let's talk about how you found us on the map. How did you find Middle Tennessee State University, and how did this come into one of your career aspirations?
I was looking for the place where I can be a researcher and also do teaching. I wanted to be this teaching research scholar, and I find that this is a perfect match. And the more I go, the more years I'm here, the more I see that I'm a good fit here. And I myself am a first generation student. And I met all my students, maybe 95% that I mentored, are first generation students. Okay. And just seeing them, how they transition, you know, from very shy and undetermined what to do, and to, oh, I'm going to do this, I'm going to apply, and I'm going to present research, I'm going to apply for graduate school, or I'm going to participate in this conference. This is just remarkable, you know. And just to see how their lives are changed, how I can, my little help can help them and their families to pursue the things they might not even probably have considered before.
And I love the fact that you picked us because you, not only for the research opportunities, but for the opportunity to touch and teach others. And I got to see you in action myself as part of Expanding Your Horizons, EYH, which is our outreach to middle school girls about careers in science. And I saw some of your amazing projects that you were doing to kind of fascinate and captivate them. Talk about the importance of giving back in that way, encouraging young women to think about and pursue scientific careers.
So as you know, women in STEM is a big problem of having women in STEM, and physics and engineering in particular. In physics, it's like 10 or 15% are females. Like, I'm the only female tenure track faculty in our department. And when I came here and I saw, like, we have like 30 or 35% of our undergraduates are females, I'm like, what do we do with them? So I decided, okay, let's organize a women in physics group. Now, every year, we have this, due to Judith Gross from a chemistry department, we do this, we started to do physics workshop for middle and high school students, and every year, we improve our presentation. And what is very fascinating to me, actually, I see that students who are presenting after the presentation, they are so happy. Actually, they are happy because they see that what they do has effect on high school and middle students, and they want more students, a female student in STEM. So what we also do, we bring our undergraduate female students from Women in Physics group to conference for undergraduate women in physics. This is a huge conference nationwide in different location in United States. And I found that this has really, really big impact on our students. So first year when I was here, I brought my first MTSU female students with me to conference to University of Virginia. And most importantly, after listening to these high-profile talks, women with very successful women, and these talks and very interesting talks, they actually got encouraged. They literally changed after coming from the conference. Before going to the conference, none of them wanted to go to graduate school. But after coming from the conference, their focus actually shifted. Both of them applied to graduate school. One of them is Kristen Barton. I'm so proud of this. This is my first student, undergraduate student, MTSU. So now she's doing Department of Energy research in Los Alamos lab, which is fascinating. And she will probably become a data scientist in one day.
Well, Professor, this is just wonderful to hear all of these great pursuits and all this great mentoring and all of your achievements, both in the field of science, but also working with their students and encouraging young women to pursue science. We appreciate you coming on the program via Zoom and sharing all this with our viewers. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
And we'll be right back.